We just do our normal loose painting. There's our colours if you want to look before we begin. This is a CAD yellow. This is a lemon yellow deep. This is only lemon yellow. That's lemon yellow. That's sienna, raw sienna. This is raw umber, burnt sienna, light red and burnt umber. Alizarine, cad red, cobalt blue, ultramarine blue, Payne's grey and black, Windsor blue, Payne's grey and all that. This is Van Dyke black, dark, and that's it. I'm just using this brush for wetting in, same time, more or less. Now this, I'm on an old brush here. This is an old brush. Never throw away old brushes. This is a squirrel, and it will give you some nice rough edges. I'll just put some sienna on. This is burnt sienna. Now I'm making some clouds coming this way across. Now see that reddish colour of the sienna. Make sure it's more or less the same all over. Now it'll start soaking in now. Now I'm going to get some blue ultramarine, and I'm going to change it a bit by adding some Payne's grey into it. I don't want it so bluey, so this is a bit darker. You can put burnt umber into it, you know, and it doesn't look too bad with burnt umber. I'm trying to shape them a bit. A couple of clouds there. I would like a different colour of blue than that. It's a little bit not quite what I wanted. That will just bring in some foreground. Now this foreground I'm going to bring in with some raw umber. Raw umber. It's safe to use it. Now let's think. Okay.
No, I'm just trying to make it an interesting. Little painting out. It's nice to have a little bit of a dabble like this and not worry about things. Just make them up as you go along. So you can try a little bit of alizarine in that. Huh? That's and I tell you what, that's okay like that, isn't it? You could let's just think here. Now, as long as you've got a basic shapes in place and you've got your perspective right, you can let yourself go and you found you'd be okay with this. Now what? Now you need some darkness in here. We need some really dark. So let's see if we can get some dark. This is burnt umber and dark, darkish blue, indigo. See? Now we want it really dark, so let's see. We'll have to have some breaks in it down that then. You have to learn to make your brush do the work. I just can't get all my hands level. There you are, get copying. Sometimes I think it looks better if you let yourself go and don't bother about what it looks like so much. You can't be too careful. If you go tight, very tight with it, it looks as though it's machined on you now, some way. So I try and be as loose as I can and put as little as I can in. As long as you get the general outside shapes of the houses and something like shape of a tree, don't go too near it. Don't put all the branches in and all the leaves. It's only sketching. When you go out, you can sketch things and jazz them up a little bit. A little, more or less a little bit more colour if you want it, but if you do go overboard with reds and on the roof there, or you better swing it a bit on the other side, going a bit darker than lighter, and not bright reds, like burnt umber. But try and keep everything in the scene tonal-like. Don't get your different values of your colours too far away from one another. If you was to see two houses like that, they probably would both have the same roof colour. They wouldn't have mixed the roof colours when they were putting those roofs on, would they? Same with the darkness of the trees. Don't have one too light against the other one too dark. You have to balance them up. And you need some light on the ground where the light's falling down on the ground. You can't just have it too dark, all dark. I hope you'll get something else from maybe copying these, but I don't want these guys who are creators. If they are doing it, don't do it online, blatantly.